Excel podcast is sponsored by MrExcel. Pivot table data crunching, chapter 14. Get pivot data. Well, you know, as you may know, I travel around the country doing Excel seminars, and I always talk about pivot tables during those Excel seminars. And one of the questions, there's two questions that I get. One, why can't pivot tables be formatted better? Why can't we teach it a template of how we want it formatted so when we recreate the pivot table or update the pivot table month after month after month, it looks right? And then the second question we get is, what the heck is get pivot data? Why is it so evil and how do I turn it off? All right. I never or very rarely get anyone who says, oh, hey, get pivot data is the greatest thing ever. But it turns out that those two questions are really related. And the solution to getting a pivot table that's formatted involves get pivot data. So I'm going to go take a look here at sheet 6 where I've created the world's ugliest pivot table. I mean, this just has all kinds of data that I'm never going to need. It's very ugly. You'd never be able to print this out and have this look correct. But then I'm going to come here where I've created not a pivot table, but just a regular old worksheet. And this worksheet has been formatted to show exactly how I want the data. So I have extra blank rows here. I have division totals here. I have a date stored, 7/31, and I formatted that date to have words before it. And then little formulas to figure out if we are before that date or after that date to get either actuals or budget. All right, and so what I'm going to do, let's just remember this one cell here, this cell, Northeast January actuals. We're going to go find that cell in the pivot table. So Northeast January actuals, perfect, it's right there. So that's the cell that I'm interested in. We need to make sure under pivot table options that we have generate get pivot data turned on. Now, not the options button, but the options dropdown. Make sure that that's turned on. You might have turned it off. It's very common because most people hate generate get pivot data. So we'll come here to our report. We're going to type an equal sign and then go to our pivot table, choose, what was it, January? Was it Northeast actuals? Click enter. Perfect. All right. And now we actually have to confront this formula and figure out what's going on with our formula. So let's take a look at the formula we get here. The problem with GetPivotData and the reason that it just is so unfriendly is that they've hard-coded a lot of stuff. They've hard-coded that the region's Northeast. They've hard-coded that the month is month one, that the measure is actuals, that the year is 2011, and that's why it doesn't work. So what you have to do after creating this first GetPivotData is you want to replace that hard-coded Northeast with a cell reference. So instead of having Northeast there, we want cell A6. And oh, by the way, I'm going to press F4 1, 2, 3 times to lock it down to column A for the measure. I don't want to hard code that to actuals. I want to use the word that's up here in cell B5. And I'll press F4 1, 2 times to lock that down to row 5. For years, we're going to be hard coded. Actually, we can leave that hard-coded to 2011, or we can ask for the year of cell A2, press F4 once to lock that down. Now, for the month, we're going to use the month of these values here, that Jan, Feb, Mar is actually a date that's been formatted to show Jan, Feb, Mar. So here where we have date of 1, I'm going to ask for the month of this particular cell. Again, we'll press F4 1, 2 times to lock it down to the row. All right, so we'll press enter. We should get the same answer, 277,435. The benefit now, though, is that that is a formula that can be copied. We'll paste special formulas, and you'll see that the numbers automatically update. All right, so now we have almost the perfect situation. We have a, let's make our formula bar small again. We have a report here that is formatted perfectly, and that report is getting its data from a pivot table. So every month we paste new data to the bottom of the raw data, we come to pivot table options, we refresh the pivot table, and then go to our report, which will now be nicely formatted and have data coming from a pivot table. So this is, I call this the new pivot table model, where we're not actually ever printing the pivot table, but we're printing a nicely formatted report that uses get pivot data to get the right numbers from our pivot table. So I think a very different way than most people go. I used to create my pivot table, recreate it every month, and then change it to values and then do formatting. I don't have to do that now. I just create an ugly pivot table, know that no one will ever see it except for me, and then use GetPivotData to populate the good formatted version for you. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.